Hello everybody and welcome to another Transformers knockoff review. I say that lightly because this is the Mechanical Team, Mechanical Alliance, MT-02. It's kind of an oversized, reworked version of the studio series. Scrapmetal, the little one, as he's known in Revenge of the Fallen. This is the second figure in this oversized series. The first one was Rampage. Really looking forward to getting this one out and about. I've got a couple more en route, actually. I believe it's Hightower I've actually got coming next, and then Long Haul. So let's just spin around the box. Mechanical Alliance, again, just him in his vehicle mode. So without further ado, let's crack it open. And here is the little one in all of his glory, vastly bigger than his studio series counterpart, with some gorgeous paint applications as well. We've got the cat symbol kind of shown all over. I don't think it was cat, to be honest with you. I think when he was shown in the movie, he was actually a Volvo. Don't quote me on that, but I see why they've gone with cat. It's a construction company, etc. It's a very, very odd character, Scrapmetal. Because he's shown as kind of this character who's used for parts. First of all, they show Scrapper, and then they show him in the second shot in his vehicle mode. Then they throw him down into the ocean, and he's then torn apart for parts. And then suddenly he pops up again in the background when they're forming Devastator. So, yeah, make that what you will. I think they should have had like a second Scrapper. I think that was the idea. And this was kind of just fodder as part of the Constructicons, but he got used, and we got a figure out of it in the end, and it's not a bad figure. I like how he kind of forms that part and parcel of Devastator, filling out that kind of claw section. And yes, it probably would have been better done another version of Scrapper, but at least we get a different vehicle, a different bot, and an overall slightly different look at Devastator compared to what his movie counterpart was. And that's not necessarily a bad thing, is it? With the likes of this, we've got the Studio Series one. We've got the Devil Savior one as well. We're going to have lots of different Devastators, so it'll be interesting to see just who can make theirs the most screen accurate. Getting up close and personal, we've got a really nice look at that face sculpt there. Isn't Caterpillar the brand spelled Cat-a-pillar as opposed to Caterpillar? I don't know. Well, it's really clean looking figure. Probably a little bit too much range there on the legs. Could do with having these tightened slightly, because he does become a little bit back heavy. But we do have these really hefty die cast feet, which holds him upright, and the paint applications on him are absolutely sublime. Whether the decals are right or not, that's up to the user, I guess, but he definitely looks the part, and he does come with more accessories other than just this random shield that Hasbro and Takara decided to produce. I mean, in all fairness, the accessories are designed for his vehicle mode. I'll show you when we get him transformed up. But this is like a hydraulic cutter, which will come down, and we can use that to kind of cut things up. That replaces the scoop. And we also get this grappling hook piece with all of these chains. And this fits on in his combined form. This is what Devastator fires to climb up that pyramid section. Getting done in the same yellow. Nice detailing. And these just, if you pull these back, they should just tab on like so. And like so. There we go. And we've got this lovely chain section as well. But it's not bad. It's a nice little accessory. It just kind of fits on the top of the hand like so, then yeah, use it to fire up when we're going to get him fully combined. In terms of scale, considering he is the little one, That's not that little, is it? This is our Studio Series version, albeit it's the Black Mamba version, but it's identical to the Studio Series. Comparing that to this version, it's just the paint apps, isn't it? They've really gone to town with it. Done an amazing job just filling out all of that extra detailing. Just kind of highlighting what is already a really good sculpt, but just kind of gets lost. Really impressed with how that looks. To give you all an idea of his scale, these are my oversized MPM style figures, apart from Bumblebee, who's actually the MPM Bumblebee. I think that actually scales pretty decent with the Black Mamba Prime. And of course, we've got one of my twins there. That's the Human Alliance version. I think that scales pretty decently as well. I've got my Rampage off of his stand because I believe, don't quote me on this, but looking at some of the fan-made scale charts, they've got Rampage down as about 22 feet and Prime is 28. And I think Megatron's like 32. So I've kind of tried to stagger that slightly. So I've got Rampage kind of knuckling his way around. So even then, so definitely does not look out of place with the rest of these characters at all. Let's just take a quick look at his articulation, shall we? The head can look up and down. We can go left and we can go right. Really nice sculpt on there. We've got an up and down motion on those shoulders, albeit very, very stiff joint in there. Full rotation in there. There's a ball socket just in the top there. Come out to the side. And we've got a little bit of tilt on there as well. We've got a kind of pivot on the back of the arm there. So you can bring that down. We can bring that forwards. Got a ball socket on the elbow. We've got this claw section, which can open and close. There's not really anything on the waist. It's all kind of one fixed unit due to this kind of excavator digger section on the back here. But the legs can come forwards, backwards, out to the side, all the way out. Like I say, the crotch thrusting is a little bit loose. These don't tab in as nicely as I would like. You can kind of give them a real good push, but I might have to put a little bit of kicky or something on there just to tighten those up. We have thigh rotation. We do have a bend on the knee in two places. Not a really great deep bend on that knee, but he does enough for a giant construction bot. And we do have the up and down on those toes. They do work independently and they are die cast. So it's definitely enough there to keep us going, I think. I love the fact we can just kind of bring those arms up and kind of hunch him up. And look at the paint detailing though. That's just really what separates him from the other versions on the market. Now, transformation is not the most complex of transformations. You want to just rotate these legs around, straighten this up, make sure that everything's kind of pushed in together on those feet. Again, rotate this piece around, and this is going to disengage from the crotch panel. These chest pieces are going to come away like so, and away like so. And this panel at the front here is going to pull down. I do love this kind of spinal column that we've got going on here. The head will come in and this is going to rotate around like so. And into that void like so. And with these crotch panels down, this is going to come in. That's going to tab. That's going to push in and tab. And the leg is going to come around. And there's this tab section here. That's going to line up, and there's also a tab piece here. So you're plugging in at two points on both sides. So same with this side, bring that round. One and two, just pushing and tabbing those into position. Remove this really handy shield. the scoop section is going to push in. This is going to come round and push in. Like so, the arm is going to come down. That's going to come all the way down, like so. This is going to come forwards. And this piece is going to rotate around and around, and this is going to come down and fill in that void piece like so. It's already starting to come together, isn't it? It's just a shame they went with the cat logo. I'm sure that it was a Volvo. I'll have to check now, and I'll put that in the notes section of the video. This piece again is going to come forward using that rocking hinge. This is going to rotate. If you look, there's this tab just on the side piece here. Push that down, lock that in, and push and tab that all into position. In you go, and then making sure everything is kind of lining up, we can then put this section. Which way do we go? We go this way, so that slides in that void. There we go, that one there, and that one there. It's going to push down and square off. We can bring this panel up and just make sure that these slide into place. And there we go. There we have him in his alt mode, from tracks to the back of the cab piece. Rear there, we're looking just over the 5-inch mark, so around 13 to 14 centimeters. And comparing that to his Studio Series brethren, he definitely towers over him. It kind of makes him look like a Matchbox toy. And alongside the MPM sized Optimus Prime, albeit the Legendary Toys version, again, that's not too bad. If you're going by the door size, this is a fairly small excavator. It is one of the smaller ones from the movie, so you know, that's not too bad. I love how the vehicles kind of scale with the MPM line, but the bot mode scale with the oversized MPMs. Now to switch out this front piece, that's just on a slider, so that's gonna, which way are we gonna go? We're gonna go down, aren't we? Slide that piece down. We can then slide back in like so. A lot harder to get that one in than it was to get the other one out. And then we can have this come down for that like 2 seconds of footage that it had in the movie. But I do actually like that. I prefer that to the scoop, but each to their own. It is kind of on a hydraulic piece here. It slides up and down. Got a hinge top here, hinge here. This piece can fully extend. So I mean, we've got a fair bit of length there. And we do have some wheels. I've got this roller at the front and these panels at the back here. He does roll pretty well. And the die-cast feet do tuck away nicely at the back there, giving us just enough clearance. But I will just switch this out just so we can get him in his combined form. It's not the most complex of transformations to get that there. You do have to remove this shield. And that'll fit onto Rampage or Skipjack there, depending on whether they do a big Skipjack as well. You want to just untab this piece here. And this is going to come up on this tight hinge. That's going to rotate around. We're going to use this ball socket. That's going to rotate. I think we're going to go this way, aren't we? And then we bring this down as a claw. Let's have a look, because this is going to come down as well. So yeah, that is the right way. This piece here is then going to come up. Again, we're going to lift this piece up and over, bring this piece around. And we're going to bring out that claw like so. And then this piece is going to come all the way through like this. And these are going to form the kind of hand claw sections for our Devastator. We have his attachment panel here. This is what's going to plug in to Hightower. And if we bring in our grappling hooks, you see those tabs there and tabs there. These should, he says, this way round, I think. There we go. Plug in just on the underside there, and then these will fire and they go and they grapple on to wherever He's going. So I've obviously got these facing the wrong way on here, haven't I? Ugh, rookie mistake. But yep, it's nice that we've got these little grappling hook sections. Then they're not perfect at all, but it's fun to have these little accessories. I think I'll have them on when he's in Devastator mode, just because it's a nice little addition. They all just kind of fire out and grab. Yeah, certainly a different approach to it, I think, and I like it. It's nice having these small accessories. Still got nowhere really to put the shield until we get a skipjack, because it looks ridiculous on Rampage. It just doesn't go with his color scheme at all, and it's nice to have this little piece here as well. Really looking forward to getting Hightower so we can see kind of what this guy is going to look like as an arm and what sort of size it's going to be. Really nice pieces. I'm still going to be collecting the Black Mamba trade off KOs of Studio Series as well, because I'd like to have one oversized, maybe have these as my robot modes. I don't know. I'd like to make it work in several different modes. I actually quite liked how the Devastator looked on screen. I didn't like how he was used or why he was used. I certainly didn't like his kind of genitals swinging around there, but I actually quite liked it in the movie, and I'm really liking it in toy form thus far. Huge shout out to TF Direct for making this review possible. I've included a link in the description below where this can be ordered, and until next time, for myself and the oversized version of Scrapmetal, aka the little one, goodbye.